أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الف لام ميم. تلك آيات الكتاب الحكيم. هدى ورحمة للمحسنين الذين يقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة وهم بالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. The beginning of Surah Luqman is very similar to the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. Many of you might have recalled. There we have Alif Lam Mim Zalika Al-Kitabu La Rayba Fih Hudan Lil Muttaqeen. Here we have Alif Lam Mim Tilka Ayatul Kitabil Hakim. These are the ayat or the revelations of a book which is wise, full of wisdom. Hudam wa rahmatan lil muhsinin. It is a guidance, and not only a guidance, but a mercy, but for those who attain to the level of excellence about their religion. In Surah Al-Baqarah, it is muttaqeen. That's the starting point. Hudan lil muttaqeen. It is a guidance for muttaqeen. But now it is muhsineen. Those who have attained excellence in this deen. For them it is rahmah. Hudan wa rahmatan lil muhsineen. Alladheena yuqeemuna as-salata wa yu'toona az-zakata wa bil akhirati hum yuqinoon. Who establish the prayers and they pay the zakah. And they are absolutely convinced of hereafter. Here actually the word yaqeen is used. Yuqinoon. They are fully convinced that another life we shall have and we shall be resurrected from the dead. And then the life of the akhirah, that is the real life. As we read in Surah Al-Ankabut, وَإِنَّ دَارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانَ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. Actually, the house of akhirah is the real life only if they had known. أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدًى مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. These words are exactly the same as we find in Surah Al-Baqarah. They are the people who are on guidance of their Lord, and they are those who will attain salvation and prosperity and success. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ. And from people there are some who go and buy frivolous discourses. I will explain it, what it means. لِيُضُلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. So that he leads astray people from the way of Allah, from the path of Allah without knowledge. وَيَتَّخِذَهَا هُزُوَا. And they take this, that is Quran, the ayat which are being revealed to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, in a mockery. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. Those are the people for whom there is going to be humiliating chastisement. Now this has been the practice of the evildoers in all times. Keep the common people busy in such things that they don't listen to something which is serious. They don't have a time to ponder over serious things. Keep them busy. Either, you know, in playing, singing. So there was a person, Nadr ibn Haris, who was amongst the very staunch enemies of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he saw that the people of Quraysh at Makkah, they are attracted by Quran. They go to listen Quran from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To distract them from that, he brought a singing girl from Persia. And the stories of ancient Persian history. And he said, read these things. Don't pay attention to what Muhammad is saying. These stories are much better than what Muhammad is relating. And go and listen to this singing girl. You will enjoy. Why do you go and listen to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And in this our present age and civilization, these games, they have been designed by Satan to keep people busy. Either you work hard for earning, or you are just enjoying life and busy in the external world. You never have an opportunity to peep down your own hearts, to search your own souls, to think about who we are, where we are, where we are heading, what is going to be the end, what is happening, why it is happening. Are we having humiliation in this world? If it is so, why? What are the reasons? Never think about it. We eat and drink and be merry, or if you have some spare time, well, keep attached to the television or watching the baseball game and so forth and so forth. So these are the tactics of those people who want that the message of Allah should not spread among the masses. وَإِذَا تُطْلَى عَلَيْهِ آيَاتُنَا And when our ayat are recited to him, وَلَّا مُسْتَكْبِرًا He turns away in arrogance. قَالَّمْ يَسْمَعَهَا As if he had not even listened to them. قَالَّ فِي أُذُنَيْهِ وَقْرًا As if there is some heaviness in his head, in his ears. فَبَشِّرْهُ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, give him the glad tidings of a painful chastisement. Now, this is a taunting attitude. Glad tidings, not warning. But you know, for them the glad tidings are those of painful chastisement. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ النَّعِيمِ As for those who come to believe and do good deeds, for them there will be the gardens of bliss. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا They will abide there forever. وَعَدًا عَلَيْهِ حَقًّا This is a promise true on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ And He is almighty and all-wise. خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ بِغَيْرِ عَمَدٍ تَرَوْنَهَا He has created the heavens without any pillars that might be visible to you. وَأَلْقَى فِي الْأَرْضِ رَوَاسِيَا And He has fixed mountains on the earth. أَنْ تَمِيدَ بِكُمْ So that it should not shake with you. وَبَسَّ فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ دَابَّةٍ And He has scattered and spread in this earth all types of animals. وَانْزَلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً And we sent down water from heaven. فَأَنْبَتْنَا فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ زَوْجٍ كَرِيمٍ And then we caused to grow therein of every noble kind of growth. هَذَا خَلْقُ اللَّهِ This is all creation of Allah. فَأَرُونِي مَاذَا خَلَقَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ دُونِهِ Now let me see what those other gods have created whom you think that they are also associated with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بَلِ الظَّالِمُونَ فِي ذَلَالٍ بَعِيدٍ نَيْ These evildoers are in a very clear error. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةِ This second section, it mentions Hazrat Luqman. Who was he? Two things are clear. He was neither a prophet of Allah, nor he was from the ummah of any prophet or messenger. He was a simple person. As you know, the traditions go, he belonged to Nubia. Nubia is a place, desert, between border of Sudan and Egypt, somewhere in between the two. He belonged to this Nubia place, and he was dark-colored, Abyssinian type of people. And he lived in Makkah, and he was a carpenter by profession. But he was a wise man. Now, what is wisdom actually? It is composed of two things, because this section is included in our selected course of study of Quran. It's lesson number 3. So this is very important, because the basis of Quranic philosophy, those articles are contained in this section of this surah. What is hikmah? وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةَ أَنِ اشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ And we had granted wisdom to Luqman, that be thankful to Allah. وَمَنْ يَشْكُرْ فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُرُ لِنَفْسِهِ And whosoever is grateful and thankful to Allah, he does it for his own gains. وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهُ غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ And whosoever is ungrateful, Allah is self-sufficient, he doesn't need any thankfulness or some reward from any person. And he is praiseworthy. Now two things we have to keep. One is the nature in us. And what is that nature? Actually, it's the ruh that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought unto us. This nature, this ruh, it has the dormant consciousness of Allah and love of Allah. It is there, ingrained in this nature of human, you know, human beings. Because every human being has a ruh in him. But then there is another thing, and that's the faculty of reasoning, which we call aql, the intellect. Now, if the two conditions are fulfilled, a person's nature is safe, sound, healthy, not perverted, and his intellect is also working in the correct direction, then he will reach, he will think over, who am I, what is this universe? Has it been created by itself or someone has created? If someone has created, who is he? What are his attributes? How can I love him? How can I worship him? And what is going to be the end of my life? I eat, drink, live, and then die, that's all? Or there is going to be some result of what I am doing here? If I do something good, shall I get any reward anywhere? If I do something wrong, am I going to be punished somewhere else? Now, these are the basic questions. Basic questions of philosophy, of metaphysics. So if a person, he might not be very much learned, and you know, he might not have a couple of PhDs with him, but if his nature is safe and sound, and his intellect works in the right direction, he will reach certain results. And what are those results? They are given here. When Luqman was dying, you know, he transferred the result of the fruit of all his thoughtfulness over the whole of his life to his son. The sermon to his son, you know, that has been mentioned here by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this person, Luqman, was very well known in Arabia. Just as we quote in our speeches, Allama Iqbal, he said so. In the same way, the khutaba, the orators, and the shuara, the poets of Arabia, used to quote him as a very wise person. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is here giving the person to whom you accept that he was a wise man, well, actually his position was this, that we are telling you. And this is the same, fundamentally, to which Muhammad is calling you, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْبَانَ الْحِكْمَةَ نَشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ The result of hikmah is that we should be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The nature, if it is correct, it is safe, it is sound, it is healthy, it demands that if somebody does any good to you, you must be thankful to him. If you are thankless, your nature is perverted. But who is the real benefactor? How do we know? This material world, the sun, the moon? No. Someone else. Someone who has created the sun and moon. So we should be thankful to him. Just as Ibrahim said, Inni wajjahtu wajhiya lillazi fatara as-samawati wal arda hanifa wa ma ana min al-mushrikeen. I reject the stars, the moon, the sun, and I have turned my face towards in the direction of that who has created these heavens and earth. وَإِذْ قَالَ لُقْمَانُ لِبْنِهِ The call when the Qad said to his son, وَهُوَ يَعِذُهُ And he was exhorting him. يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ Now the first result of this wisdom and thankfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be not to make any one or anything an associator with him. لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ He is alone, he is one. He has no partner, no equal, no associate. إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ Verily, associating something or someone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a very big injustice. وَوَسَّنَ الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ Now, in between the advices and sermons of Luqman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is adding, because he has said to his son, you should be thankful to Allah and you should not associate anyone with him. Now Allah is saying, وَوَسَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ, and we have enjoined upon human being that he should be kind to his parents. This is also parents have a right. Your creator is Allah, but who bore you in this world is your mother, and who cared for you, for your needs, when you were a child, are your parents. So you have to be thankful to me, number one. I am the creator. I have put this love and affection in the hearts of the parents for you. But then you should be thankful to your parents also. And we enjoined upon man concerning his parents. His mother bears him despite weakness upon weakness. حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَىٰ وَهْنٍ وَفِصَالُهُ فِي عَامَيْنِ, and his weaning is in 2 years. Now what we have said, give thanks to me, anishkur li wale walidek. Be thankful to me, grateful to me. I am the creator and I have put this affection and love in the hearts of the parents. But now actually that affection has come to you through your parents, so you should be thankful to your parents also. Ilay al-masir, in the end, all of you will be returning to us. وَإِنْ جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِمَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ, the same thing which we have read already in Surah Ankabut. But if the parents pressurize you, they strive against you and pressurize you that you associate with me anything or anyone about whom who have you no knowledge, فَلَا تُطْعِهُمَا, then you don't obey both of them, disobey them. وَالْمَصَاحِبُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا, but even then, you should keep an honorable company with them and gentle company with them in this world. وَتَّبِعْ سَبِيلَ مَنْ أَنَابَ إِلَيَّ, and you should take to the path and follow the path of that person who has turned towards me. You don't follow your parents. Be kind to them, respectful to them. This is their right. But follow if they are on the right path. Okay? This is Nurun ala Nur. If your parents are on the right path, this is Nurun ala Nur, light upon light. But if they are on the wrong path, they are not to be followed. You have to follow the one who has turned his face towards me. ثُمَّ إِلَيَّ مَرْجِعُكُمْ, then all of you will have to return to me. فَأُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, and then I will tell you what you had been doing. يَا بُنَيَّ إِنَّهَا إِنْ تَكُ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ, now again, the sermon of Hazrat Luqman starts. Oh my son, little son, إِنَّهَا, if it is, what does it mean? If a good deed or a bad deed, if it is, إِنْ تَكُ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِنْ خَرْدَلٍ, if it is of a weight of a grain of mustard seed, very small. Human deeds, they might be very small, good or bad, however small they might be. فَتَكُنْ فِي سَخْرَةٍ, or though they may be in some rock of a samawat, or in the heavens of a lard, or in the earth, Allah will bring it. يَأْتِ بِهَا اللَّهِ, all deeds will be brought on the Day of Judgment and you will have it. We have it in the last para. مِسْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِسْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِسْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. If you have done, even you know, equal to the weight of zarra, an atom, you will see it. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَطِيفٌ خَبِيرٌ, verily Allah is very subtle and aware of everything. يَا بُنَيَّ, O my son, أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ, establish the prayer. When you have come to know Allah, He is the Creator, He is the Sustainer, now you establish a psychological relationship with Him through Salah. Go on addressing Him, praying Him, 5 prayers a day. Why? So that you remember. Aqimi Salat al-Zikri, we have read it in Surah Tutaha. Aqimi Salat al-Zikri, for my remembrance. Aqimi Salat wa'amur bil ma'roof, and enjoin upon others whatever is good. وَنْهَا عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, and forbid them from whatever is evil. وَاصْبِرْ عَلَىٰ مَا أَصَابَكَ, and then you have to bear with patience and perseverance whatever comes on you. Because when you will enjoin people to do good, maybe some people are angry with you. When you stop people from doing something bad, maybe they beat you, they come on you, they attack you. So all these things can happen. Because truth is bitter. Nobody is going to like this. So then you have to bear with forbearance and patience whatever comes to you. Inna dhalika min azmil umur. Verily, these are the matters requiring strong character. Only a person who has a strong character can do these things. وَلَا تُصَعِبْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ. And don't turn your cheek away from the people haughtily. وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا. Don't walk on the earth in a boastful manner, haughtily. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورٍ. Verily Allah doesn't love anyone who is arrogant and boastful. وَقْسِدْ فِي مَشْيِكْ. And be modest in your way, gait and walking. وَغْضُضْ مِنْ صَوْتِكْ. And lower your voice. إِنَّ أَنْكَرَ الْأَصْوَاتِ لَصَوْتُ الْحَمِيرِ. Definitely the most unpleasant voice is the braying of the donkeys. أَلَمْ تَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Don't you see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has subjected to you and to your service whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. وَأَصْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَهُ ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنَةً. And He has perfected upon you His blessings, whether they are visible or invisible. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يُجَادِلُ فِي اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. And there are people who argue about Allah and fight about Allah and argue against Allah, although they have no knowledge, وَلَا هُدًى, no guidance, وَلَا كِتَابٍ مُنِيرٍ, nor any book which is bright and illuminating. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمُ اتَّبِعُوا مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ. And when you said to them, we should follow what Allah has sent down. قَالُوا بَلْ نَتَّبِعُوا مَا وَجَدْنَا عَلَيْهِ آبَانَا. They said, no, we shall follow on what we have found our forefathers. But what their practice, we shall continue. أَوَلَوْ كَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ يَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَىٰ عَذَابِ السَّعِيرِ. What? Will they keep on following their forefathers? Although it is possible, it might be, that the Satan had been calling them to the chastisement of the blazing fire. وَمَنْ يُسْلِمْ وَجْهَهُ لِلَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ. And whosoever surrenders and submits his will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he has attained excellence, فَقَدْ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى. So now he has his hand on the firm handle, hand hold. وَإِلَى اللَّهِ عَاقِبَةُ الْأُمُورِ. And definitely the end of all the affairs is with Allah. He will decide. وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَلَا يَحْزُنْكَ كُفْرُ. Whosoever disbelieves, so O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, don't grieve over it. إِلَيْنَا مَرْجِعُهُمْ. They have to come to us. فَنُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا عَمِلُوا. We shall tell them what they had been doing. And we shall recompense them. We shall reward them. We shall punish them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. Verily Allah knows what is in the chests of the people. نُمَتِّعُهُمْ قَلِيلًا. We are providing them for this life. But what is this life? A few days, few years, that's all. نُمَتِّعُهُمْ قَلِيلًا. ثُمَّ نَسْتَرُّهُمْ إِلَىٰ عَذَابِ الْغَلِيظِ. And then we shall harshly, and we shall drive them, push them, towards the harsh chastisement. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ. And if you ask them, who has created the heavens and the earth, they will surely say, Allah. قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ بَلْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Say, then praise, all praise is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But most of them don't know. لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. To Allah belongs whatever is there in the heavens and the earth. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ. Allah is free from all needs. He is absolutely self-sufficient. And He is the praiseworthy. وَقْلَوْ أَنَّ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ أَقْلَامٌ. Now this subject has already come first in Surah Kahf. وَلَوْ كَانَ الْبَحْرُ مِدَادًا لِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّي لَنَفِدَ الْبَحْرُ قَبْلَ أَن تَنْفَدَ كَلِمَاتُ رَبِّي وَلَوْ جِئْنَا بِمِثْلِهِ مَدَدًا. This ayah in the end of Surah Al-Kahf. This subject is being repeated here. وَلَوْ أَنَّ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ أَقْلَامٌ. And if all the trees on this earth become pens, وَالْبَحْرُ يَمُدُّهُمْ بَعْدِهِ سَبْعَةُ أَبْهُرٍ. And the ocean, and to it are added seven more oceans, and they work as ink. ما نفذت کلمات اللہ، دی ورڈز آف اللہ ول ناٹ بی ایگزاسٹڈ. اینڈ آئی ایکسپلین ایٹ دیٹ ٹائم وٹ ڈز اٹ مین. ایوری کریشن آف اللہ از دی ریزلٹ آف ہز ورڈ کل. سو آل دی کریشنز دے آر ورڈز آف اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی. When he decides something to create something, it says kun, and it becomes. So these are the words of Allah. So by these words of Allah, it is meant here is the creations of Allah. You can't count them, you can't write them. Impossible. مَا خَلْقُكُمْ وَلَا بَعْثُكُمْ إِلَّا كَنَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ. Your creation of all of you and your resurrection of all of you is nothing but like the creation and resurrection of a single soul. It's so easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can create you and recreate you. Then, and it is for him as easy as creating one human soul. Inna Allah sami'un basir. Verily Allah is all listening and all seeing. Alam tara anna Allah yulijul layla fin nahar. Don't you see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala merges the night into the day. Wa yulijul nahara fil layl. And sometimes he is merging the day into night. وَسَخَّرَ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ. And he has subjected the sun and the moon for your service. كُلٌّ يَجْرِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. Every one of these is running its course for an appointed period of time. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. And that whatever you are doing, Allah very well knows it. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ. And this is because Allah is the truth, the whole truth. He is the truth. هو الحق وأن ما يدون من دونه الباطل. And whomsoever they are calling besides him, they are just falsehood and nothing else. وأن الله هو العلي الكبير. And that Allah is the one who is great. أن الله هو العلي الكبير, high and great. ألم ترى أن الفلك تجري في البحر بنعمة الله. Don't you see that the boats and ships, they sail in the sea or in the rivers, بِنِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ, with the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِيُرَيَكُمْ مِنْ آيَاتِهِ, so that he shows you some of his signs. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِكُلِّ صَبَّارٍ شَكُورٍ. Verily, in this are signs for those who are persevering and grateful ones. وَإِذَا غَشِيَهُمْ مَوْجٌ كَالظُّلَلِ. But when they are in sea or ocean, and when a wave covers them like clouds, it's a very high wave is coming, just as the clouds, you know. دَعَوُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. At that time, they call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, promising him their total obedience. مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُمْ الدِّينَ. We shall obey you, O Allah, and none else. Please deliver us from this affliction which is coming. فَلَمَّا نَجَّاهُمْ إِلَى الْبَرِّ. And when Allah delivers them to the land, فَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدْ. There are among them, they start some in between. They worship us also and others also. And they take the middle road. وَمَا يَجْهَدُ بِآيَاتِنَا إِلَّا كُلُّ خَطَّارٍ كَفُورٍ. And our ayat are not rejected except from those who are unfaithful and ungrateful. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ. O mankind, have fear of Allah, your Lord. وَخْشَوْ يَوْمًا. And keep fearing that day. لَا يَجْزِي وَالِدٌ عَنْ وَلَدِهِ. When the father will be of no avail for his son. وَلَا مَوْلُودٌ هُوَ جَادٍ عَنْ وَالِدِهِ شَيَا. Nor the son would be of any avail to his father. إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ. Everyone will have to bear his own burden. Everyone will be accountable in his individual position. كُلَّهُمْ آتِيهَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدًا. We had it in the end of Surah Maryam. إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ. This promise of Allah is true. This time is coming. It will come. It is to come. فَلَا تَغُرَّنَّكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا. So let not the life of this world deceive you. وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ. And let not that biggest deceit, arch deceit, that is Satan, deceive you by pleading Allah is all forgiving. Now this is one of the very big, you know, ways of deceiving of Satan. He says, Allah is forgiving. Okay, go on doing what you are doing. You are eating haram, okay, go. Allah is forgiving. He will forgive you. So this forgiveness of Allah is forgiving. But Allah punishes also. He is unkaqam also. Although he is ghafoor, but he gives you punishment also. So that is, you know, we have to keep in between. We should keep on hoping for the forgiveness of Allah. But keep on at the same time fearing the chastisement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bain al khawf wa rajaf. We should keep our position in between. The fear, there should remain. But hope that Allah may forgive us. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ. Verily, it is only Allah with whom is the knowledge of that hour, when that hour as-sa'a will come. Only He knows. وَيُنَذِرُ الْغَيْسِ. And it is He who sends down rain. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ. And knows what is in the wombs of the mothers. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ. And nobody knows, no soul knows. مَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا. What that soul is going to earn tomorrow, some good deeds or bad deeds. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ. And no soul knows in which land it will die. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. Verily, Allah is the all-knowing, all-aware. Now we come to Surah Al-Sajda. This surah, having 30 ayat and 3 sections, was very loved by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So much so, that it was his usual practice that on the morning of Friday, in the Fajr prayer, in the first rakat, he nearly always recited this surah. In the second Surah Al-Dahr, in the first Surah Al-Sajda. And this he did also on the mornings of the Eid's festivals, Eid al-Fitr, Eid al-Adha. So this shows he had a special relationship, special love, special affection for this surah. And this surah actually, in its style, is very similar to Surah Yasin, which will be coming inshallah tomorrow. We shall be reading Surah Yasin also. Both these surahs are very close in style. The flow and rhythm is very fast. And you know, it is as if it shakes within me and you something. It has a special effect. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. This is the last of the 4 surahs which start with Alif Lam Mim here. Surah Al-Kabut, Surah Al-Rum, Surah Al-Luqman, and now this Surah Al-Sajda. Alif Lam Mim. تنزيل الكتاب لا ريب فيه من رب العالمين. The sending down of this book, and there is no doubt in it, is from the Lord of the worlds. Now this style. تنزيل الكتاب لا ريب فيه من رب العالمين. أم يقولون افترى. Do they say Muhammad has forged it, composed it himself? بل هو الحق من ربك. Nay. It is the truth from your Lord. لِتُنْذِرَ قَوْمًا. So that you warn, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a nation, مَا أَتَاهُمْ مِنْ نَزِيرٍ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ, to whom before you no warner had come, لَعَلَّهُمْ يَعْتَدُونَ. So that maybe they take to the right path. They take the guidance. اللَّهُ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ. Allah is He who created the heavens and the earth and whatever is between them in 6 days, 6 periods of time, 6 cycles of time, which we can't know up till now. ثُمَّ اسْتَوَىٰ عَلَى الْعَرْشِ. Then he mounted on the throne. There is one concept about Allah, especially among the philosophers and the followers of Aristotle. Allah is the creator. But now, this universe is going on by itself. Allah has to do nothing with it. Just, you know, as a footballer, he kicks the ball. Now ball is moving. He kicked it. Okay. But now the ball is moving itself. The player has nothing to do with it. So they have this concept. But Quran says, and says it over and over again, He created, then He mounted the throne, then He controls it. ثم استوى على العرش ما لكم من دونه من ولي ولا شفيع فلا تتذكرون. You have no intercessor and no protector besides Him. So you are not, are you not admonished? يدبر الأمر. He is ordaining the affair of this universe. He is controlling, He is running the universe. يدبر الأمر. تدبير. يدبر الأمر من السماء إلى الأرض. His commands come from the heavens and they are being executed on the earth. ثم يعرج إليه في يوم. Then you know the reports of what has happened. They also return to Him. And this cycle, في يوم كان مقداره ألف سنة مما تعدون, it's equal to 1,000 years according to your count. This we have already read in Surah Al-Hajj also. وَإِنَّ يَوْمًا إِنَّ رَبِّكَ كَأَلْفِ سَنَةٍ مِمَّا تَعُدُّونَ. One day in your Lord is equal to 1,000 years according to your counting. One day of Allah is equal to 1,000 years of our counting. ذَلِكَ عَالِمُ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ. He is the one who knows everything unseen or seen. Al-Azizur Rahim. And He is all-powerful, mighty, and merciful. الَّذِي أَحْسَنَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقَهُ. Who made extremely beautiful everything which He has created. Look to His creations. Everything is beautiful. Look to these flowers. Look to these plants. Whatever He has created. أَحْسَنَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقَهُ. Each one surpassing each other in beauty, grandeur. الَّذِي أَحْسَنَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقَهُ. He made it everything beautiful which He has created. وَبَدَى خَلْقَ الْإِنسَانِ مِنْ تِينَ. And then He started the creation of man from mud. Now this is the beginning of man. As the, you know, zoologists also say, biologists, that the beginning of life on this planet was at the shores of the seas, where water was coming up and going back, coming up and going back. This interaction between the clay and water, this produced the organic compounds, chemical compounds. And from the organic chemical compounds, then life, you know, emerged. And water is the source of life. So He began, He commenced the creation of man by mud, from mud. ثُمَّ جَعَلَ نَسْلَهُ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ مَاءٍ مَهِينٍ. Then He made His progeny, continuity of His race, through the extract of a despised and hate-worthy liquid. This semen, nobody even wants to mention it. But that is the beginning. And that is the continuation of the species. This, you know, this is with which procreation is going on. ثُمَّ صَوَّاهُ. Then He fashioned Him. وَنَفَغَ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِهِ. And now this is the stage. And then He blew and breathed unto Him, into Him, from His own spirit. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ. And then He made for you the ears to listen, the eyes to see. And afida, I have told you before also, I take it to be the faculty of reasoning here in brain. It's a big computer over here. You are feeding, you know, data is being fed into this computer through eyes, through ears, through touch, through smelling. All these are sense organs. And through these sense organs, you are this brain is being fed. It that processes all this data and then infers. And in this way, you know, the human knowledge, the acquired human knowledge has increased. قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ. But there is very little that you thank. We have done this much for you. وَقَالُوا أَيْذَا ظَلَلْنَا فِي الْأَرْضِ أَيْنَّا لَفِي خَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ. إِنَّا لَفِي خَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ. And they say, when we will be lost in the dust, we will die, we will be buried, our body will, you know, disintegrate, we will become dust again, and we will be lost in the dust. Are we going to be created again? بل ہم بلقاء ربہم کافرون، نے ایکچولی دے آر ریفیوزنگ ٹو میٹ دیئر لارڈ، دے ڈونٹ سے دس از امپاسبل، ہاؤ کین ایوری بڈی سے اٹ از امپاسبل، اف دس یونیورس کڈ بی کریٹڈ وائی کانٹ اے مین بی کریٹڈ اگین، سم ون ہیز کریٹڈ دس یونیورس، ہی ڈیڈنٹ کم یو نو ایز اے بال فرام بلو، سم ون ہیز کریٹڈ، سو ون اف ہی ہیز کریٹڈ دس یونیورس کانٹ ہی کریٹ یو اگین، اٹس سو سمپل لاجک، بٹ ایکچولی وائی ڈو دے ریفیوز، دے ہیو نو فیس ٹو میٹ دیئر لارڈ، دے نو وٹ دے آر، دے وانٹ ٹو اسکیپ، دس از دی اسکیپزم، بل ہوں بے لقاء ربہم کافرون، دے ڈونٹ وانٹ ٹو میٹ دیئر فیس، بل الانسان علا نفسہ بصیرۃ، ایوری بڈی نوز ویئر ہی اسٹینڈس، قل یتوفاکم ملک الموت الذی وکل بکم، ٹیل دیم او محمد دی اینجل آف ڈیتھ ہو ہیز بین گیون یور چارج، ہی ول take your souls summa bi ila rabbikum turja'un, then you will be returned to your lord. walau tara idil mujrimuna nakisu ru'usahum ru'usahum inda rabbihim, and only if you O prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam could see this scene when these guilty people, they'll be standing before their lord on the day of judgment hanging their necks heads down. Rabbana, and they'll be saying at that time, Rabbana absarna, oh our Lord, now we have seen, wasami'na, and now we have listened, farji'na, so please send us back to that world from which we have come. Na'mal salihan, we shall do good deeds now. Inna muqinoon, we have the total belief and faith now, so please give us a chance and return us. Walau shayna la atayna kulla nafsin huda, Allah would reply, had we so wished, we would have given guidance to each one soul of this universe. If we had to give it by force, we could give it to Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab. Could they resist? No. But actually, وَلَكِنْ حَقَّ الْقَوْلُ مِنِّي, this thing has come from me. I am testing you, and whosoever deserves to go to paradise, he will go to paradise. And whosoever will deserve to go to hell, well, he has to go to hell. And I had made this decision beforehand that I shall certainly fill hell with the jinns and mankind altogether. The hell has also to be fed. So you are the fodder of this hell. فَذُوقُوا بِمَا نَسِيتُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا. Now taste. Taste this chastisement because of that you just ignored and you just forgot the meeting of this day. Just forgot that you have to come to us. إِنَّا نَسِيْنَاكُمْ. Now today we are ignoring you. Go away. وَذُوقُوا عَذَابَ الْخُلْدِ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. And now taste the everlasting chastisement for what you used to do. إِنَّمَا يُؤْمِنُوا بِآيَاتِنَا الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهَا خَرُّوا سُجَّدًا وَصَبَّحُوا بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ وَهُمْ لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. Verily only those people really believe in our revelations who, when they are admonished and reminded with our ayat, with our revelations, they fall down on their faces and in prostration, and they glorify their Lord with his praise, and they are not at all arrogant. This is ayah of Sajda, please. بسم الله اوله واخره تتجافى جنوبهم عن المضاجع. Such of our bondsmen, they keep away from their beds during the night. يدعون ربهم, calling upon their Lord, خوفا وطمعا, with fear as well as hope. That I tell you, بين الخوف والرجاء, always remain in between fear also and hope also. So, يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفٌ وَتَمَعًا, hoping also and fearing also. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ, and whatever we had given them, provided them with, from that they spent. فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنٍ. So, nobody knows what has been hidden, مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ, من قرت عائن ایز اے ریکمپنس فار واٹ دے یوز ٹو ڈو نو بڈی نوز دس آئی از ویری امپورٹنٹ وائی قرآن ٹیلز سچ اینڈ سچ بلیسنگ ول بی ان جنہ دیر ول بی ریورس فلوئنگ ایون آف ہنی اینڈ ملک اینڈ سو آن اینڈ سو فورتھ دیر ول بی وائن بٹ دیٹ وائن ول ناٹ بی It will not have bad effects in it, but it will be there. Sharaban tahura, very pure wine. So all these things. But Allah here says, nobody knows what delight of the eyes is kept hidden. Further. So there are two stages of the reward of Ahlul Jannah. One is nuzul. The other is ziyafa. Nuzul in Arabic means when some guest has arrived, he has alighted down from the cart or formerly from the horse or from the camel, he is called nazil. He has descended from his sawari, his markab, on which he was traveling. And you immediately present something. If it is summer, some cold drink. If it is winter, some hot drink. This is nuzul. But then now he is staying with you. Now you prepare the feast for him. That is the second stage. Now he is Zayf. It is called Ziyafa. Starting, in the beginning he is Nazil. And for him is Nuzul. And now when he stays with you, he is Zayf. And now you arrange Ziyafa for him. Now you have to prepare the feast for him. So these all things which are mentioned in Quran, in Surah Ar-Rahman, Surah Al-Waqi'ah and so forth and so forth. These are all nuzul. The first blessings of Allah which will be given to these people, to the bondsmen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are these things. But you know, then when they will dwell in the paradise, then what Allah will give them, nobody knows. And there is a hadith also. مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَاتْ وَلَا عُذُنٌ سَمِعْتْ وَمَا خَطَرَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ بَشَرْ Which no eye has ever seen, no ear has ever heard of, and there has been no idea of that coming to anybody's heart. Those will be the real blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his true bondsmen. فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ عَيُنٍ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ It will be the reward for them. أَفَمَنْ كَانَ مُؤْمِنًا كَمَنْ كَانَ فَاسِقًا So think yourself, whosoever is a believer, is he like the one who is a transgressor? Are they equal? لا يستوون No, they can't be equal. أَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ As for those who came to believe and they did good deeds, فَلَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ الْمَعْوَى For them there will be the gardens of abode. نُذُلَمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ Now this word is here, نُذُلَمْ This will be the immediate hospitality which will be presented to them. وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ فَسَقُوا As for those who transgressed from مَأْوَاهُمُ النَّارِ Their abode is the fire. كُلَّمَا أَرَادُوا أَنْ يَخْرُجُوا مِنْهَا مِنْ غَمٍ Whenever they will try to come out of the fire due to the grief, وَعِيدُوا فِيهَا They will be thrown back into it. وَقِيلَ لَهُمْ And it will be said to them, زُوقُوا عَذَابَ النَّارِ الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ بِهِ تُكَذِّبُونَ Now taste the chastisement of the fire which you had been belying. There's not going to be any Jahannam. These are all stories of the ancient. Tilka Satirul Awwaleen. There's no reality in these things. Now see, is it real or not? وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ This is very important ayah. Chastisements divided into two categories. Smaller chastisements or the nearer ones. And the final chastisement, or the bigger one. Whenever some messenger was sent to some people, smaller chastisements came to the people, so that if they are sleeping, they should wake up. You know, they should think over it, what this messenger is saying. Awakening them from their slumber. But then, after the messenger has done his work, and he is conveyed to them fully, the message of Allah. and they have finally decided to reject him. Then the large and the bigger chastisement of annihilation, and now extermination of the nation came to them. وَلَنُزِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ. And we shall certainly make them taste the nearer or the smaller chastisement before that greater chastisement, that perchance they may return. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ ذُكِّرَ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِ. And who is more evil-doer than the person who has been admonished by the revelations of his Lord? ثُمَّ أَعْرَضَ عَنْهَا. And even then he turns away. If somebody is calling him on his own, giving his own sermons, okay, it is a different thing. But when someone is being admonished with the revelations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he turns away, it means he is the biggest culprit. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ ذُكِّرَ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِ ثُمَّ أَعْرَضَ عَنْهَا إِنَّا مِنَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُنْتَقِمُونَ. From such culprits, we shall definitely take revenge. Now Allah is not only Ghafoor, He is Muntaqim also. He takes revenge also. So both these conditions should remain before us. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ فَلَا تَكُنْ فِي مِرْيَةٍ مِنْ لِقَائِهِ. And we had given before you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the book, Torah, to Moses, Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam. فَلَا تَكُنْ فِي مِرْيَةٍ مِنْ لِقَائِهِ. So you should have no doubt whatsoever about receiving this book from Allah. Because before you, Torah was given to Musa. وَجَعَلْنَاهُ هُدًى لِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. And we had made it, declared that Torah to be the guidance for the children of Israel. As we have declared this book, Quran, to be the guidance for the whole of mankind. But for Torah, وَجَعَلْنَاهُ هُدًى لِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا. And then we appointed from among them leaders who used to guide the mankind with our command. Now from the Ummah also, you know, all the ulama, all the pious people, all the saints, Muslims, they have been calling towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the same way, in Bani Israel also, there were good people also. As a whole, we know that, you know, evil dominated in them. But it doesn't mean that they didn't have any good person among them. There were good persons also. They had good days also. A number of prophets had been coming to them. جَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا. But those people who could lead their people to the right path, they must fulfill two conditions. لَمَّا صَبَرُوا, number one. They should be patient. They should not be ambitious in this world. If they are ambitious in this world, then how can they have time to call people towards something good, to teach them something good? They have to cut down their own aspirations of this world. وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ. And they should have full conviction in our ayat. They must themselves be fully convinced of the book and the revelations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then they will be able to call people and guide them to the right path. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ هُوَ يَفْصِلُ بَيْنَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فِي مَا كَانُوا فِي يَخْتَلِفُونَ. Verily your Lord will decide between them regarding all those things on the day of judgment, regarding all those things in which they had been differing. أَوَلَمْ يَهْدِ لَهُمْ. Is it not sufficient for them as guidance? كَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنَ الْقُرُونَ. How many a generation we destroyed before them. يَمْشُونَ فِي مَسَاكِنِهِمْ. They also used to walk in their dwellings, in their cities, in their townships. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ فَلَا يَسْمَعُونَ. And in this are the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So are they not listening? They are not paying any heed to it. أَوَلَمْ يَرَوَ أَنَّا نَسُوقُ الْمَاءَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ الْجُرُسِ. Secondly, don't they see that we drive water to the barren land? فَنُخْرِجُ بِهِ زَرْعًا تَأْكُلُ مِنْهُ أَنْعَامُهُمْ وَأَنْفُسُهُمْ. And then we bring forth from that barren land crops out of which their cattle and their themselves eat. This is again a sign. Will they not then see all these signs of our authority, of our power, our creative potential? Everything is before them, their eyes. And they should keep their eyes and ears open, that they'll find, you know, everything testifying to the existence and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَقُولُونَ مَتَى هَذَا الْفَتْحُ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Now when they had nothing more to say, the mushrikeen and the kuffar, they finally, you know, requested that they used to put was, when will be this decision? If you are correct, if you are truthful, tell us. When this chastisement would come? When this decision will be between you and us from your Lord? قُلْ يَوْمَ الْفَتْحِ لَا يَنْفَعُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِمَانُهُمْ. Tell them, on the day of that decision, if people now at that time say we come to believe, it will not be beneficial for them. We've already read it. Even Fir'aun, of the time of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, when he was drowning, he said, Amantu, I believe in Allah, the Lord of Musa and Harun. I believe in the same God in which Bani Israel believe. But now this is rejected. When you see the signs or the actual chastisement coming, now it's no use accepting. No use saying you believe. The time is gone. قُلْ يَوْمَ الْفَتْحِ لَا يَنْفَعُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِمَانُهُمْ وَلَا هُمْ يُنْذَرُونَ. And they will not be given any respite. No time. At that time, it will be said, now the time is over. Just in the examination, when it is declared, time is over, stop writing. Finished. Whatever you have written, you have written. Now wait for the result. فَأَعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ. So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, turn away from them. Don't pay any heed to what they are saying. Don't be grieved or what they are plotting, what intrigues they are doing. وَانْتَزِرْ. And wait for the final judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُمْ مَنْتَظِرُونَ. Verily they are also waiting for the final decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number, 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together, we can make a difference.